Hello Trade Pros. In today's video, Victorio is going to walk you through a tutorial of how to find trading zones in Nasdaq and how to qualify a trade so you weed out and filter out the bad trade opportunities and leave yourself with only the high probability, low risk trade chances. Let's jump right into this video.
Hello YouTube and Trade Pros, it's Victorio from Trade Pro Academy with another video for you guys. In today's video, I want to talk to you guys about finding trading zones and using them to set up trades, how to use them in conjunction with qualifiers to set up the perfect trade entry and or exit, or even how to use them in conjunction with disqualifiers. So let's get right into it. In front of me, guys, you can see that this is a Nasdaq dominant screen. We have the 10 tick right here, the 6 tick down beneath it, and then we do have the footprint up here along with the pivot chart for Nasdaq and its correlations. Down here we do have a delta and a volume chart. So this could be used for equities and commodities alike, mainly any kind of future asset. So let's get right into this analysis. What I like to do is look at a 10 tick, usually a higher tick chart to begin with, and then scale down from there on different time frames and different charts. So right here, guys, you see this is the 10 tick for Nasdaq. This is the open right here, this little yellow line. If we scroll a little further this way, you can see the open right where this little yellow line starts. Once we zoom out, we can see that there is a lot of stuff drawn, kind of convoluted, but all these gray rectangles are our trading zones, and they're gray because they can be either resistances or supports depending on where the price is at right now. As you can see, it is above this little gray box right here. So this box right now will act as support, and it's underneath this little gray box right here, which will act as resistance. So you guys might be thinking, how do I draw these levels? Well, to draw these levels, you can look at past sessions. Right here we have yesterday and the day before session, so coming back from Monday, this should be enough to draw your levels. So what you do is you take confluence levels that have had a lot of trouble being tested and broken out of. Right here is a good example. You see these little highs here. It tests this area a few times, couldn't really break above it the first few times, and finally broke through with some fight. You can draw a level down here, but that is a lot farther away than the price at right now. We're trading at 71.79 right now. This level's all the way down at 71.30. So we can draw levels that are a little closer to that. So right here you can see this was a huge test, could not break under it about 7 to 8 times in total over the overnight session and the day session. So that is a very strong level. You guys can see down here it also came into it today. It tested that level, could not break it, and it bounced right back up and didn't look back. So taking highs in confluence with areas that have had a lot of trouble breaking through become solid trading zones, supports or resistances. Right here there was a battle like we talked about before. Right here another battle right under this open. You could see it tested a few times to the upside and to the downside, consolidated within it before breaking out, had a lot of fight between the buyers and the sellers. Then today, off the open, comes into this level, tests it a few times before swinging lower, and then comes back to test it 5 more times before breaking right through and then retesting it to the upside. So zones that are either choppy tops or bottoms can be constructed as strong trading zones or resistances and supports in confluence with other zones that kind of look similar that align with them. So another trick is looking at these colorful lines right here, which represent the open, the overnight lows, highs, and what have you. So if these coincide with the zones that you've drawn, they become that much stronger, guys, which is another trick. So after having drawn our zones, we look to enter into a trade. So we have to be patient, guys, and don't really rush into things. You've drawn those zones for a reason. You might as well use them. If it's in the middle of a zone, kind of like this coming into the open right here, but it's in between two zones, kind of sandwiched, there's no point in just buying it or selling it right in the middle of the zone. The best trade idea is to wait until it starts to come into your zone to qualify a trade. And we do use different charts to do that. So we can look at a 6 tick, which is right here. that I'm circling right now. This is the exact same as this, just on a more intricate time frame. These are 6-tick reversals instead of 10-tick reversals. This is used to highlight zones a little better, and you can see to the side here we have the delta bars. The longer they are, the longer the support resistance. Doesn't really matter what color they are. And then we look over to the footprint right here, guys. This is a very vital tool in picking out our entries and exits. So you see these little buy imbalances right here that flash, these little green numbers that flash. Then to the other side, you have the sell imbalances, which are red numbers that flash. These buy and sell imbalances are great levels in which to enter on a trade idea. So buying into strong buy imbalances that stack up against each other like this you see here would be a strong buying zone. Right here, these buy imbalances that stack up one above the other are strong buying zones, but only if you are looking to buy and it is coming into your buying zone. Don't just buy it blindly into these buy imbalances without having direction or any other qualifiers. These imbalances just mean on a diagonal like this, we have come up with a 5 times greater buy imbalance. So the 27 is more than 5 times the 2 that were traded down here, and it works in that way. So the higher the number that is highlighted green, the stronger the buy imbalance, and you do want to see buy imbalances stack up against each other to create stronger buy levels. So right here, as you can see, this level held pretty well, these 3 buy imbalances that formed on this candle. This candle right here that was printing is the equivalent to these 2 little candles right here. They came down into the buy imbalance area. They could not break beneath, and now they're kind of trying to rally higher. But this footprint is more so used to qualify the entry than it is to qualify a level. Remember, we've drawn our levels already. And in conjunction with these levels, we can also look at the pivot table right here. This is for NASDAQ. Again, the pivot is drawn right here at the 61.69 level. And also the R1 and R2 are drawn here, S1 and S2. These are very strong resistance and support levels for any futures, honestly. These are very good to look at. When price comes in this pivot level right here, because NASDAQ is right above it, it will hold a strong support, and we could see many bounces off before it breaks to the downside. It can continue higher off this as well. So keep in mind to have those pivots when you are watching price come into your level. And down here, guys, we have the delta chart and the volume chart. The way this works is, first, I'd like to look at the volume chart, and the darker the blue, that means the higher the volume traded at that level. So these can be used as support and resistance levels as well. So when a lot of dark blue stack up kind of like these two right here, this should prove a strong support to the upside. And if it's to the top of a range like this, if it's at the top of a level, it could prove as strong resistance to the upside. So it could bounce off that level and continue lower. Then we turn over to the delta right here, and this is just the difference in between the bid and the offer. If the number is red, that means there are more orders that sold through that level than there are buyers. And this could be used in conjunction with this volume chart right here. So the darker the red or the darker the green, it could be seen as a stronger support or resistance level. Again, we do pull our ladder over, and this is a vital tool in trading right here. So you want to look at where the inventory is at, and that acts as a magnet in conjunction with all the other stuff I told you guys. But what's important to do while finding the perfect trade entry is to look at price coming into the levels you've drawn. You've drawn those levels for a reason, so why not use them, right, guys? So let's see if we can find a little trade for you guys. This was a quick little intro to how to set up a perfect trade entry and how to use your trading zones effectively. So let's practice what we preach and find a little zone for you guys and enter into a trade and see what we can do with it. So we'll do this analysis on the fly right here. You see correlations to the top right of my screen are kind of on highs. Equities are on highs, bonds are on lows. Pretty bullish signal. It's coming into our support level right here, which comes in conjunction with the VWAP at the 71.74 level, which also happens to be the overnight low indicated by this green highlighted number right here. On the 6-tick, you can see there's a lot of support down here as well. It bounced off this level multiple times. Down at the 74s, we do have some heavier buy imbalances coming into previous time right here. If we pull the chart a little further down, we can see at these 74s, even a little below that 72s, a lot of buy imbalances have formed, but that was a while ago. So let's see what we have right here. More sellers are coming in. The sell and bounces are forming, guys. Volume chart right here. The darker the blues are to the bottom here. Correlation still ticking up. You see there are not that many dark greens down here to act as support. More of the dark reds. But again, the open is right here. So honestly, guys, our next best trade is something that looks like this. So if we extend the open from there right here, it's at the 78. So we want to see this crack, retest maybe, and then pull higher. Or come down to our trading zone and then pull higher on some higher buy imbalances forming around these levels right here. So let's take a little break and see how that goes. You see the inventory is to the upside right here a little. You see 35, 29, 35, flash 35 here to the bottom. There's not that many in the 30s. So let's wait it out a little and see how this goes. See, our entry got hit, guys. Kind of looking a little weaker, though. You see all these sell imbalances print here. Correlation starting on the downtick. But it is in our very strong support level, so we do have a little patience with this trade. What's a little concerning is a lot of the volume is coming out to the downside. You see increase on the downside, so we'll see how this plays out. These buyers are desperately trying to hold on to this. Some buy imbalances showing up here. A little more buyers coming in. The inventory was heavier to the upside. Remember, you can always scratch a trade if you don't like how it's looking. The VWAP in conjunction with this trading zone should hold as pretty strong support. These little wicks down on the 6-tick here indicate that the buyers are buying up the price pretty rapidly, not really letting sellers have their day. Alright guys, so it's a little fast forward into our trade. We entered right around this area right here at the 74s, you guys saw, and then it came a tick within stopping us out, but this huge white wick candle convinced us that it'll continue along a little higher, maybe back into the open, and then we continue to take full profit just here, 5 points above our entry, guys. So you guys saw how we got in and used our trading zones to our advantage to begin to qualify our trade. The price action was currently in the middle of our two trading zones. We told ourselves that if it breaks out of this open right here and drops down and continues higher, we would look to pick it up. Or if it came into this trading zone right here as support, we would look to pick it up. And that's exactly what we did on higher buy imbalances and using our volume and delta graphs, guys. So that is it. I hope you enjoyed this video. And comment, like, share, and subscribe. Let us know what you think about this video down in the comment section below. And that is it.
All right, and there you have it. I hope you've enjoyed today's video and you've had an opportunity to learn how to find high probability, low risk trading zones and how to better qualify trade opportunities. Remember, it's not about taking just any trade. It's all about being patient for longer, so only the good, worthwhile trades end up being the ones that you execute on. Nothing's worse than reviewing your day at the end and seeing a lot of trades that just shouldn't have happened and were disqualified for a number of reasons. So if you learn how to qualify your trades based on criteria and be patient for longer when you're doing a review at the end of the day, you're gonna be proud of what you've done and accomplished. I'd love to hear from you how you're gonna apply this to your trading strategy. Pop that in the comments below and please like, comment, share, and subscribe. We got a lot of awesome content coming your way. Until next time, manage your risk and trade like a trade pro. Take care and goodbye.